Welcome back to Crash Course in Entomology. Today, we'll be learning about the external anatomy of insects and the insect integument. Insects have had millions of years to perfect the evolution of their external bodies, leading to their characteristic tough exoskeleton and their multifaceted limbs. The first of the insect's external features we'll be learning about today is the insect mouth. Insect mouth parts are a unique structure that changes depending on an insect's style of feeding. At the most basal level, an insect's mouth features from top to bottom the labrum, the mandibles, the maxillae, and the labium. Another structure, the hypopharynx, is analogous to a tongue and is seen in many insects with chewing biting mouthparts. To aid in function, the lower mouthparts of an insect, the maxillae and the labium, each possesses a pair of palps. These mouthparts fall into several categories. Chewing biting mouthparts are found in orthopterans, blatodeans, hymenopterans, odonatans, and coleopterans, as well as many other orders of insects. Chewing lapping mouthparts are similar to chewing biting mouthparts, but also use an organ to lap up food. Piercing sucking mouthparts at a general level are an identifying feature of the order Hemiptera, but can be found in many other orders. These mouthparts are used to feed on fluids hidden behind a membrane. Rasping sucking mouthparts are used to wear away at tissue to feed on whatever material it oozes out of the feeding site. Sponging mouthparts absorb liquid foods into a canal for feeding and are employed by the common housefly. Finally, siphoning mouthparts, found commonly in lepidopterans, are unfolded into a straw-like organ for drinking fluids, usually nectar. The antennae serve as the primary sensory organs of insects. These organs can be divided into three main regions. In order, these are the scape, the pedicel, and the flagellum. The flagellum are heavily segmented into subregions called flagellomeres. Antennae are incredibly important organs and will be featured much more in depth in future videos. Insects have three pairs of legs, with each of these legs following the same basic structure. The five leg parts of insect from the body outwards are the coxa, the trochanter, the femur, the tibia, and the tarsus. Like the antenna, tarsus is divided into subsegments called tarsomeres, ending in a pair of tarsal claws. The legs of insects are often modified into different forms for the niche the insect occupies. Running legs, like those of a cockroach, are known as cursorial legs. Legs modified for jumping, as exemplified by the hind legs of orthopterans, are called saltatorial. Swimming legs seen in aquatic beetles are known as natatorial legs. Grasping legs come in two different forms, with prey-capturing legs such as those seen in mantids called raptorial, and legs used for holding onto surface called prehensile. Some types of leg modifications are seen in incredibly specialized groups. For example, corbiculate legs modified for pollen carrying, and fossorial legs modified for digging. One of the most important adaptations gained by the insect class was the exoskeleton, a complex system of non-living material separating the insect from its environment. The insect integument is the outer covering of an insect, which includes the exoskeleton, also known as the cuticle, as well as the epidermis and basement membrane. The insect integument has many different functions, including defense, coloration, sensation, water conservation, muscle attachment, and respiration. The cuticle is the outermost region of the integument. It has different layers, each with specific functions, and is made of non-living material. The three layers of the cuticle are the epicuticle, the exocuticle, and the endocuticle. The epicuticle is a rigid outer layer. Its primary purposes are coloration, protection, and water conservation. The epicuticle contains a layer of wax that keeps water both in and out of the insect's body cavity. Coloration on the epicuticle is provided through microsculpturing, where microscopic formations reflect light. The exocuticle and the endocuticle contain a substance known as chitin, which is an incredibly durable protein. The strength of the exoskeleton is a result of the arrangement of chitin within it, with minuscule rods of the proteins called microfibrils in a helicoid arrangement. The exocuticle contains chitin proteins which have been cross-linked in a process known as sclerotization. The exocuticle cannot be digested, so it's shed in each molting. It can also provide coloration through pigmentation. The endocuticle is more flexible than the exocuticle and is not sclerotized. It is digestible, so it's absorbed by the insect upon each molt. The epidermis is a layer of living cells and is the only living region of the integument. This layer contains many specialized cells, including dermal glands, which produce the cuticle's waxes, exocrine cells, which secrete pheromones, sensory neurons, and support cells. Finally, the basement membrane is a matrix of polysaccharides that separates the integument from the insect's body cavity. In order to keep internal muscle structure, insects have ingrowths of the integument called apodemes, which serve as attachment points for muscles. Due to the rigid structure of the exoskeleton, it must be shed for an insect to grow in a process known as molting. Molting occurs in a series of complicated steps as follows. Step 1, apolysis, in which the cuticle separates from the epidermis. Step 2, the space between the epidermis and cuticle is filled with molting fluid. Step 3, the new cuticle is secreted on top of the epidermis. Step 4, the old endocuticle is digested by the molting fluid. Step 5. Dicotyl lines form along the spots of weakness on the old cuticle and begin to split. Step 6. Ecdysis, in which the insect escapes from its old skin. Step 7, and the final step, tanning, in which the chitin in the exoskeleton sclerotizes and darkens. The process of molting is controlled by a system of molting hormones, mainly the juvenile hormone and ecdysone. Ecdysone is the hormone that, when present, triggers molting. In the presence of ecdysone, if juvenile hormone is high, the insect will molt into another juvenile instar. If juvenile hormone is low, the insect will grow into the next life stage. The shed left behind after a molt is called the exuviae. Flexibility in the cuticle is provided by arthroidal membranes, regions of the cuticle with increased mobility due to a lack of sclerization. These regions are usually apparent between joints and body segments. In regions that need to be more flexible than the arthroidal membrane alone can provide, the elastic protein resilin can be present, acting as a molecular spring. Resilin is usually present in the joints of saltatorial legs and in the joints of wings. Sensation on the cuticle is provided by sensory hairs, and respiration is provided by openings called spiracles. However, we will go more in depth on insect sensory biology in a future video. Coloration is important, providing functionality in mating, defense, and camouflage. Coloration in insects can be a result of two different mechanisms, chemical coloration and physical coloration. Chemical coloration is derived from the pigmentation in the exocuticle and endocuticle, and physical coloration is provided by the microstructures on the epicuticle, which can cause iridescence. Well, everybody, that about wraps up this video on insect external anatomy and the integument. Please subscribe for more lessons in entomology, and leave a like if you learned something new. Until next time, this has been Crash Course in Entomology.